to all of you. I am Mr. Shashikant B.Gosavi, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am presenting the uses of contour maps, another online educational resource from my course. The learning outcomes desired for this course are listed as the students will be able to use contour maps to draw contour profile for selected alignment, to set contour gradient of root alignment, and to calculate the capacity of reservoir. To begin with, we will see what is a contour profile. A contour profile is normally a profile of the land surface corresponding to a selected alignment which is taken up on a contour map. Here, for example, I have taken a contour map in which you can see there is a mention of contour interval of 5 meter. There is a mention of scale graphically as well as numerically, and the map is showing the values of the contour RLs at every 25 meter interval. Between every two successive contours, vertical distance is 5 meter. So it begins from the bottom, slowly rises up to that particular circle which is drawn over there, and then in the inner portion, once again, it falls down, reaches to the bottom. So it is indirectly creating a crater over here or a reservoir over here at the center. To draw a contour profile, an alignment has to be chosen. Here, we have chosen alignment connecting A to B, and across this particular alignment, wherever there is intersection of the contour lines, all those points are of utmost significance to us. See here, there is an intersection at this point for a contour of 7725 RL. There is intersection at this point corresponding to the highest point available along this alignment. Then there is an intersection at this dark contour of 7725 once again. Then there is an intersection of 7700. And successively at every 25 meter interval, whatever are the intersection, those have been marked. At each of these points, what we have done is we have drawn a vertical ordinates passing through these particular points. All these in all 13 number of lines are there which are passing through the points of our interest, and those have been vertically projected down. In the next contour profile, you can see that I have drawn a graph of vertical ordinate of respective RLs. We have shown 7550, 7600, 7650, 7700, 7750, and 7800 contours. Reduce the levels of contours. And if vertically projected lines are taken up along these particular horizontal lines, you can find that the intersection of these two lines is happening at these points. So this is corresponding to 7725. This is corresponding to 7744. This is 7725 again. This is corresponding to 7700. This is corresponding to 7675, 7650. 7628 is the lowest point, and again on the right hand side there is a rise, 7650, 7675, 7700, 7725, 7750, and so on and so forth. So this is a classical profile which we can draw from a given contour map, which helps us in identifying how the ground surface varies along a given alignment. Another important application of the contour map is that of drawing a contour gradient. See, this is very much important when we are passing a road through a hilly terrain, or we are passing a canal of desired gradient, or railway line of desired gradient across a land surface with varying terrain. See, this particular contour map which we have referred earlier is having a contour interval of 5 meter throughout, and contours have been labeled at every 25 meter interval. Here the scale has been given as 1 as to 10,000, that means 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meter. Graphically also scale has been shown over here. You know that the maximum permissible ruling gradient can be 1 as to 40. That means in every 25 meter, maximum rise permitted is 5 meter. And if a road is to be passed through this particular terrain, we will have to be cautious about that. Let us say that we are starting from here. There is a contour line which has been drawn at this location having a RL mentioned over here as 7725. So from here to here, this particular subsequent successive two contours are having a difference of 5 meter. For getting a difference of 5 meter, one has to travel a distance of 200 meter such that the gradient will be 1 as to 40. And therefore, what I have done is, by taking this as the center, I have drawn a circle with 2 centimeter as the radius. Therefore, automatically this particular distance comes out to be 200, and with the same respective radius with the subsequent point, I have drawn another circle. You can see that this particular circle is intersecting to the successive contour at this location as well as at this location. We can choose the one which is most suitable for us. The another next distance to be traveled will have to be 200 meter for every 5 meter, and therefore I have taken this much radius and intersection point has been chosen over here. I was having option of going for 200 meter in this direction also, but in that particular case probably I might have gone in a wrong direction than what is desired by me. I want to reach to this end as early as possible, and therefore I have chosen this one. Subsequent rise is again taken up along this particular direction, horizontal distance 200 meter traveled for a rise of 5 meter. This is continued again along this distance, along this distance, along this distance, everywhere for the successive two contours having a rise of 5 meter, we have to travel 200 meter distance, and thus the contours are moving along these particular alignments. From here, I was supposed to take an exit from here, so I have ended up my respective gradient or alignment at this particular location. This is utmost essential for us to draw the contour gradient, particularly in the hilly area when hilly roads are being planned. Another classical application of the contour map is determination of capacity of reservoirs. All of us are familiar that a contour map is a drawing indicating the nature of the ground. When number of loops are around each other, as has been shown in this particular case, the contours are forming loops around each other, it may either represent a hill or it may represent a pond, pond-like land profile. What does it mean is, towards inner part, the reduced level will be lowest, and on the outer part, reduced level will be higher. So here from 7628 up to this 7748, continuously the reduced level is rising. And from here on, again it is falling on this side as well as on this side. Same thing true on this side as well as on this side. What we can see clearly is up to this 7740, continuous rise is there. So we are having so many contours drawn which will help us in finding the area between any two successive contour lines. So A0 is the innermost area, then between two successive contours it will be A1, A2, A3 and so on and so forth. We can keep on calculating the areas between every two successive contours. These areas can be put up into this particular formula. The vertical distance between every two successive contour can be put up as h, and then by using this particular trapezoidal rule we can find out the volume. There is prismoidal rule also which can also help us in finding the area. One out of these two rules we can definitely adopt and we can find the capacity of a reservoir. This is a review of what we have learned by now. Answer the following multiple choice questions. For this, you need to pause your video and answer them. Then correct answers will be elaborated by me. The first question is, contour profile is to be drawn for selected. First option is contour, alignment, gradient, and all of these. The second question is, contour gradient is useful to, first option is find alignment for desired gradient, find gradient of desired alignment, both of the above and none of those. Dear learners, the answers are very, very clear. For the first question, the answer is contour profile is to be drawn for selected alignment. And for the second question, the answer is contour gradient is useful to find alignment for desired gradient. I have used these references. Thank you very much.